हेलो क्लास सेवेंथ, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू माइट बी फिट एंड फाइन। टुडे आई एम हियर विद द डिस्कशन ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 3 ऑफ योर बुक एन एलियन हैंड। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द डेजर्ट। दिस चैप्टर इज इन टू पार्ट्स, सो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग दिस चैप्टर इन टू पार्ट्स through these type of videos. You all might be knowing what is a desert. In the class of social science, you would have discussed this concept of the desert. But anyways, here the writer is telling us about the desert and the desert animals, how do they survive there. So let's discuss. Here are a few lines. It's a kind of pre-cap of the first chapter, what is given, first part, not chapter, first part, what is given here. A desert is generally without water and vegetation. A green patch with fresh water and green trees in the middle of a vast desert is a beautiful sight. A desert may be too hot or too cold. Means we are going to discuss these main headlines in this first part. Let's start. Those of us who live in regions covered with forests and surrounded by hills may find it difficult to imagine what a desert is really like. Author wants to say here that the people who are living in the hilly areas, who are living in the mountains, regions means areas, those who are living in regions covered with forests, means those people who are living in forest areas and in such areas where the land is surrounded by hills. Such people may find it difficult to imagine. They cannot even imagine what a desert is really like. The popular belief is that it is an endless stretch of sand where no rain falls and therefore no vegetation grows. So here, the definition of the word desert has been given. It is the popular belief. Means most of the people, they think that a desert is an endless stretch of sand. Means you will see there will be sand and it will be limitless sand on the ground. It will be spread for a very far off lands. Okay. The popular belief is that it is an endless stretch of sand and in such place there is no rainfall, means there are no rains and therefore no vegetation grows. Because there is no rain, that is why no trees, plants, they grow in such land which is called desert. So this is common belief of the people about this word desert, that it is an endless stretch of sand, means all around there will be sand and sand and there will be no rains, and because there are no rains, so there won't be any vegetation. Simultaneously, it is dry, hot, waterless and without shelter. Desert is a dry area, it is a hot place, it is waterless, there is no water and without shelter, and one cannot find any shelter to take rest. Okay, there will be sand and sand, but this is not entirely correct. The author wants to say this definition is not entirely correct. This is not a complete definition. For those people who have studied about the deserts, the desert can be beautiful place, For those people who have already studied about deserts, they can understand that deserts may be beautiful places. It is the home of variety of people. Desert may be the home of variety of people, means there different kind of people may live. It may be the home of variety of people, animals and plants that have learned to live under very hot and dry conditions. So we cannot say that there is no shelter and there are no people, no animals in deserts. There are people, they live there. There are animals, there are plants who have learned the art to survive in such hot and dry conditions, to live in such hot and dry conditions. True, the ground is not always hidden by a cover of grass, plants and trees as it is in other climates. The author says that it is true that ground, the land, is not always hidden, is not always covered with the grass. You cannot find, it is true that you won't be finding any grass, means the land, means the ground will not be covered with the grass or covered with the plants and trees always, as it happens in other climates. The climate of the desert is entirely different. You cannot find, you cannot always find a cover of grass, plants and trees there. But whenever it rains, which is rare, rare means it is difficult, means it is impossible to get rains in the desert area. But he says whenever it rains, it is impossible, but whenever it rains, desert flowers bloom. Then there are flowers on the ground and the sight can be as rewarding as that of any tropical garden. And then the scene becomes very beautiful. There are flowers on the ground and it becomes a scene, same scene as that of a tropical garden. Tropical, something very hot area. So in such a place or in such a ground, in such an area, you may find flowers also, but whenever it rains. But rains are impossible thing in the deserts. A desert is not always a flat, unchanging wasteland of dry sand. Flat, plain, flat means plain. Desert is not always a plain or unchanging wasteland. Wasteland where there is nothing, where there is no vegetation, no trees, no plants. Okay, it's not always a wasteland which never changes. It is not always a plain land of dry sand. Okay, it may have mountains and hills. So these things are to be added to the definition of the deserts. That deserts may have mountains and hills. It may have an oasis, big or small. Oasis actually is a water resource, a kind of spring. But the definition has been given in the next line. It may have big or small oasis. An oasis is like a green island in the middle of a desert, where a spring, I was telling you, spring water source. Where a spring or a well gives plants and trees a better chance to grow. Okay. So he wants to say that there may be big or small oases in the deserts. And oases is a green island in the middle of a desert. And there may be some spring, there may be some well, and that well will be giving the plants and trees a better chance to grow. Here in the picture you can see, inside the desert you can see there are homes, there are people, there are trees, there are animals, there are plants, right? So such may be the condition of the desert. So that belief of most of the people is not a complete definition of the deserts. A desert may be hot like the Thar or cold like Ladakh. You know, Ladakh is also called a desert. And you know, in our state, Himachal Pradesh, Spiti, Lahul Spiti district, Spiti region is also called the coldest desert. Okay, the cold desert of Himachal. So, the desert may also be cold, but there won't be rains. There may be vegetation, there won't be rains. So, here it is written, a desert may be hot like Thar desert and it may be cold like Ladakh, coldest regions. But generally speaking, if a place has little or no water and vegetation, people usually call it a desert. So the general definition is a place which has little or no water and vegetation. Such place becomes a desert for the people. Some deserts are almost here. I think you would not have seen this. Let me show you the text. Yes, here it is. A desert may be hot like the Thar or cold like Ladakh. But generally speaking, if a place has little or no water and vegetation, people usually call it a desert. Some deserts are almost totally without water. So, in the next passage, in the next paragraph, the author is telling us that some deserts are almost totally without water. In such places, strong winds blow, raising heaps of sand and depositing them as mounds. If you visit Rajasthan through Punjab, the very first district of Rajasthan after Punjab comes Sri Ganganagar. And Sri Ganganagar district, in that district you will see such things. What? Strong winds blowing and raising of heaps of sand and depositing them as mounds. Mounds are heaps. So it is told that in such places strong winds blow and they raise heaps of sand and these become mounds. Sand is deposited in the form of mounds, big heaps. These are called sand dunes. Okay, when large quantity of sand is deposited in the form of a mound, then that becomes a sand dune that shift and move endlessly across the desert. And these sand dunes, they keep on shifting. In the morning it will be here, in the evening it will be there. Okay, they keep on moving endlessly across the desert. Few plants can survive on such dry shifting sands. And there are certain plants which can survive on such dry shifting sands, like cactus. Okay. Now, dear students, here is the comprehension check. You will find some questions here, and you have to give the answer to these questions. First is, pick out two phrases which describe the desert as most people believe it is. Means the first definition, the belief of most of the people. You have to tell two phrases to justify this definition, and that is an endless stretch of sand, waterless and without shelter. It is the answer to this question. Here are two phrases, which are, one is an endless stretch of sand and second is waterless and without shelter. Second is, pick out two phrases which describe the desert as specialists see it. Means according to the specialist, what will be the definition of desert? So that is, a beautiful place, a home of a variety of people, animals and plants. Right? These are the phrases for this answer. A beautiful place, the home of a variety of people, animals and plants. Now next is, which do you think is an apt description and why? So out of these two, which one is the suitable description? First or second? So, second option is the apt description. It is apt because human experience tells us so. Because human experience tells us so that a desert is a beautiful place. It is the home of a variety of people, animals and plants. Now, next exercise for you is, yes, the phrases on the left in the following box occur in the text. Match each of them with a phrase on the right. So here four phrases have been given on left and right. You have to match them. Okay, so the first is an endless stretch of sand. Its answer will be fertile. No, its answer will be nothing but sand as far as one can see. An endless stretch of sand means nothing but sand as far as one can see. Third option will be right answer. Third option will be matched with the first. Second, waterless and without shelter. No water and not shade. No water and no shade will be the answer to this. That is fourth. Second will be matched with fourth. An oasis. Oasis is a fertile place with water and plants in a desert. Third will be matched with first option on the right side. Hidden by a cover of grass. Not visible because the grass is thick. So the fourth will be matched with the second option. That will be your answer to this exercise. So dear students, it has been the first part. I will be coming with the description of second part on the very next day, whenever it is the turn of our English class, and then we will be discussing the second part and its exercise questions. Okay, till then you have to read the first part of this chapter and you have to do the exercise questions. Okay, till then take care, keep reading, keep doing your homework, stay happy, stay indoors and keep doing your work hard. Thank you very much.